My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers and welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's gospel. It's the 23rd week in ordinary time. It's Monday today. Tuesday. The Holy Gospel according to Luke, chapter 6, verses 12 to 19. It happened that in these days, Jesus went out to the hills to pray. And all night he continued in prayer to God. And when it was day, he called his disciples and chose from them 12, whom he named apostles: Simon, whom he named Peter, and Andrew his brother, and James and John, and Philip and Bartholomew, and Matthew and Thomas, and James the son of Alphaeus, and Simon who was called the Zealot, and Judas the son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. And he came down with them and stood on a level place, with a great crowd of his disciples and a great multitude of people from all Judea and Jerusalem and the sea coast of Tyre and Sidon, who came to hear him to be healed of their diseases, and those who were troubled with unclean spirits were cured. And all the crowd sought to touch him, for power came forth from him and healed them all. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Recently, I met a student studying in a university far from home. She told me that she keeps in touch with her mom very often by phone, especially during exam time and difficult moments. Her mom is her courage. Yes, my dear friends, we keep in touch with the loved ones for their support, inspiration, and encouragement. In today's gospel, we see Jesus keeping touch with his Abba Father in prayer. Some might wonder what Jesus would have to pray about. Such a question may reveal a limited concept of what prayer is. It is not just a question of asking for things. It is even less a question of fulfilling a religious duty of saying our prayers. Prayer is making contact with God. the beginning and end of all things. It makes sense that Jesus would have wanted to be in intimate contact with his Father and to spend long periods of time with him. One of Jesus' main concerns was that he would do the will of his Father. Prayer was one way of making sure that there was complete harmony with that will. Luke's gospel shows Jesus at prayer more than any of the other gospels. That's why it is called the gospel of prayer. Prayer is a theme that is dear to Luke. He also shows Jesus praying before all the important stages in his public life. Today, as soon as the period of prayer was over, he calls together his disciples and from them he chooses 12 as apostles. Let us hear the call of Jesus today. First, to be his disciples, totally committed to accepting and assimilating his message. Second, to accepting the responsibility of spreading the gospel actively through the way we live, through how we speak, and through the relationships we establish. Thirdly, let us reach out and touch Jesus so that we may experience his healing wherever we need it. Let us pray. Guide me, Lord. You are my heart. You are my strength. You are my hope. Teach me, Lord, and guide my way. I love you more each passing day. Amen. Have a wonderful day, my dear friends. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I am Father Stephen Pereira, Carmelite priest, and my WhatsApp number is 9481263229. Don't forget to share this audio along with its message to your friends and contacts. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.